A cation is a positively charged ion that has more protons than electrons. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. If an atom has an unbalanced number of electrons, it becomes charged and is known as an ion. Ions can have either a positive or negative charge. An ion that has more electrons than protons has a negative charge and is known as an anion. As previously mentioned, a cation has more protons than electrons, which makes it positively charged. And this is the ion that we're focusing on in this video. In order for a cation to form, one or more electrons must be lost. And for this to happen, it typically means that they have been pulled away by other atoms with a stronger affinity. The number of electrons lost indicates the charge of the ion and is shown after the chemical symbol. For example, if silver were to lose one electron, then it would be shown as Ag positive because now it is positively charged. In general, it's actually possible to predict whether an atom will form an anion or cation by looking at its position on the periodic table. For example, halogens always form anions, whereas alkali and alkaline earth metals always form cations. Most nonmetals, such as carbon, oxygen, and sulfur, form anions, whereas most metals, such as silver, iron, and nickel, typically form cations. Some elements are able to form both anions and cations under certain conditions. An example of this is hydrogen, which can gain an electron to become H negative or lose an electron to become H positive. The elements that are located in group 18 of the periodic table are known as noble gases. They typically do not form ions because their arrangement of electrons makes them unreactive. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.